Now, Jaguar cars actually started out as the Swallow Sidecar Company, hence SS in Blackpool, and they made sidecars. But their first foray into cars was basically upgrading Austin 7s, and here's a very rare example of an upgrade, a Kent registration from the 1920s, with Swallow, later Jaguar, expertise built in. Very, very nice. And here we have a 1933 Jaguar coupe. At this stage, the word Jaguar really didn't exist. It wasn't coined until 1935 as a model name. So this basically is a SS coupe, and absolutely gorgeous, showing beautiful classic lines, an authentic vehicle, award-winning, and no wonder, jetpack. Now we have a 1937 SS Jaguar, 1.5 litre, registered in Burnley, although currently having a DVLC replacement Old London registration. Beautifully restored. Spent much of its life in Milan, in the showroom of a Jaguar dealer there, but has been, and then was sold to an owner in Holland, and then brought back to the UK, and put back to UK standard. Hence the fact, but it was originally a UK car, so it always has been right-hand drive. Very, very nice, a very rare car, not many of them around. Next, we have another SS Jaguar, slightly later one. Gorgeous cream colour. Again, a replacement registration, we don't know what it originally was. Beautiful lines, just look at that. Beautiful streamlining. No wonder people's love affair with Jaguar started before the war. Next, we have a replica, really, Suffolk manufacturer replica pre-war SS Jaguars. This has got a replacement Scottish registration. British Racing Green. Built in 2010. Hand-built replica of the iconic 1937 SS100, based on an XJ6 chassis, but very far removed from an XJ6. Next, we have a Jaguar 1.5 litre saloon, Mark IV, 1946. Although Mark IV was a mark which was, I think, unofficial as such. Very nice car. Nice cream colour, four doors, a successful businessman's car from the era, or professional. We now have a Jaguar Mark V, 3.5 litre from 1949, two-tone mauve and black, London, authentic London registration from the era, four door. Clearly a successful stockbroking year for its owner. Beautiful car. And the early post-war sports cars, the XKs. This is an early XK 120 from 1950. It lived some of its life in Australia. The nice registration of 120 Jag. Jet black, picture oneself driving down the country lanes in this to join one squadron to to fly ones, I think from the era, probably one's Vampire or Venom fighter. Very nice. Another XK, this one in a beige colour. Again, a replacement registration, AS was Ayrshire, not fully issued. Next go 120 from 1953. It was originally owned by a family in Los Angeles, California, and has participated in international rallies. It's been as far as Russia. That's further than I've been. Nice vehicle, metallic silver. We then have a saloon, big old saloon. FO, I think, is a replacement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're within about 2 or 3 minutes of the Spitfire flypast. 225, and it's Flight Lieutenant Tony Parkinson. So, eyes skyward at 225, and
I think
generally,
this is Mark,
these guys are
Mark 9?
On the button. So,
maybe.
Eyes peeled.
Mark 7, Mark 9.
And let's have a superb.
Let's go for Mark 9, shall we? This is a, I'm not sure if this is replica or real, it looks like a C type to me, a racing Jaguar. Not a D type, hasn't got the characteristic fin on the back. Very nice. I don't, British Racing Green, I don't care if it's a replica or real, it's a beautiful vehicle. We then have an XK in white, authentic London registration. It dates from 1955, it's the later XK140.
Simon Cody on the field, please.
Using a number of Ealing comedies by the late actor Terry Thomas, we're told. So it features in a number of 1950s films. How interesting. Now we have a D-type, you can tell by the fin on the tail. It's got, appears to be an authentic registration. No doubt spent much of its life on the track, although I think it's D-types are street legal, so you can drive them around. Very, very nice. More a cockpit than a cabin. Mark II. Participated in the 1959 Monte Carlo Rally, British Racing Green. Won its class in several occasions, international rallies. Beautiful black wire wheels. Jaguar XK SS 1957. Basically, this is a D-type with some modifications. Very nice, British Racing Green. Next, we have what appears to be a racing D-type. It's actually a 1958 Lister Jaguar, built to special orders.
He's on his way. With
a very distinctive history. And he's coming in from the
marquee end, at the bottom end of the field.
Next, we have a 777. Two-tone, grey and maroon. Beautiful. Got a XK Jaguar from 1959, later XK150. British Racing Green. Original right-hand drive car. Manchester registered. Lots of innovative upgrades, including power steering. Very, very nice.
They'll be in the arena in a few minutes. So for those that want to...
Yes, if one boyfriend had one of these in 1959, a girl would have certainly felt something. Next. Next, big saloon, London registered.
The only thing is,
stored in the barn for 22 years. It's been around since restoration, UK on the continent. Well, nice two-tone grey.
That's a rough point.
And we've got a 1965 Mark II. Been driven across America and South Africa. And used to tow a caliber. Modifications. Nice maroon colour. Nice vehicle. Well travelled. Immaculate silver wire wheels. And then, of course, Jaguar acquired Daimler, which is why we've got 1964 Daimler Majestic Major Limousine here. Caps. Very few made. Very nice car. Next, we have the MG rival. It never was, the NGB rival. The Daimler Dart, SP250, was Daimler's answer to the Triumph Spitfire and the NGB. This one dates from 1960. White, authentic registration. Beautiful car. Didn't quite make it against the Spitfire and the E-Type, iconic, 1966, convertible, metallic silver. The early Mark 1 E-Types had covered headlights, this is a Mark 1. Later ones had exposed headlights. Very, very nice. And next, we come to the big saloon. 4.2. This is a Mark 10 Jaguar, 1965. Very civilised vehicle, very nice. Next we have a Mark II from 1967. Which is racing green. So we have another Mark II from 1967, 3.8 litre, metallic silver, very nice. Managing director's car of the era. Metallic electric blue E-Type, Leeds registered about 1967-68. Built to California spec, First registered in Arizona, returned to the UK in 1990 and converted to UK spec. So, so it spent much of its life in the west coast of the US. Lovely wild wheels. Next, a Daimler Sovereign, 1967. Rebuilt. Very nice car. A London registered 1969-1970 Red E-Type convertible. Very nice. Then we have, what, 10 Jagger, I think? That's a 420.
Only 52 left in the world in the UK. 1966
example. Right, okay, good afternoon everybody.
Although the registration indicates it's newer. Excuse me. Because Burnley, 1967-68. Probably a reason for it. And next we have a Carnarvon registered, 67-68. Grey, Mark II. 2.4 litre, the baby engine. Next, another Mark II. It's on Leicester registered. 1968.
Oh, it's actually a 340,
it's not a Mark
II. Later on, helping me out. Right now,
the last incarnation of the Mark II body shell, 1968.
In
this case,
that's the one of the most
unpredictable
of the
live
stock.
Built as Jaguar and Daimler examples, this was a Jaguar. Now, then we have
throughout the world,
very early X Jag.
What we're going to do with our first dog today.
Then we have a Daimler limousine. All waiting for a wedding. Derby registered. Registration probably belies its age.
I've got my little man here, and as you'll see, he's sporting his own little cowboy. And this is Cowboy Joe, everybody. Now, as you can see, our cowboy has had one too many beers in the beer tent today. He's fallen off to the side
very,
there
very
in the big
example
front.
Of the day morning.
Now, every cowboy go here.
Mark II convertible.
They all need a good horse to ride.
Time.
And this young
CX's
man
is Huddersfield. Mark II.
Exposed. This is Trevor, the steed of Cowboy Joe here.
Sorry,
and our Cowboy Joe, he was looking a little bit cross there. So we're going to see if Cowboy Joe can cope with the rodeo before we give him a chance to herd some ducks. So, are you ready for the rodeo? Quick, quick, quick. He didn't fall off. Let's see
next,
if he go the other way.
Quick, London quick. Registered, 1970.
He's still there. Give Cowboy Joe a round of applause. Come on.
I know it's a tough
one. Right. Now we're going to recreate our
back
little
to be restored.
Plains of America.
Seems to be restored.
Live stock to her.
Next,
so we've got our first set of ducks here. And to be honest, they're like a herd of buffalo. They're really heavy ducks, and they're heavy ducks with attitude.
Europe, the US, South Africa. Been around.
Look at these brutes.
XJS1, gosh, the number of people will kill for that registration. XJS.
At the moment, right nightmare. So the basic commands of the team dog you might know are away,
away, 2012. Very nice.
And when we go clockwise,
happy birthday. So, happy 30th birthday from the Wirral region. Jester registered XJ6.
But Trevor here, he's been taught on the command out. We want him to stay out from the ducks there.
The one we're going to try and do with Cowboy Joe here and his little Steve Trevor is try and get the underneath our slide there. So imagine we're trying to get these through a mountain path. We're going to try and guide them underneath here.
Series 3, thank you.
Wow, first time today! Right. Cowboy Joe is tagging on for dear life. There he is. Oh dear, he's really gone off to the side now. Right.
XJS.
We're going to try and go now back underneath the bridge over there. Try again.
I'm just going to try and make Cowboy Joe.
Yes, I had to go.
This is where I double check.
Yes.
Right, they're heading the right way.
A little bit more interesting.
Right, so there's our basic command, sort of recreating
a little bit of the American enthusiast clubs about the timeline here at the National Show, so perhaps you could tell us a little bit about beautiful XJS and Racing Green.
Well, it was a Jaguar press car.
Yes.
And I bought it in the year after it was made in 1988. So we'd have done 5,000 miles.
The dog doesn't always mean
so
lie down.
So it was used by the Royal Family.
Used by the Royal Family?
Used by the Royal Family. And they couldn't tell me anything about the car for obvious reasons, because they're sworn to secrecy, because of course Jaguar's a customer, Royal Family customers of Jaguar. So I've owned the car since 1988. It's done 37,000 miles. It's absolutely original and in mint condition.
This is little mounty there, little cowboy on the back there. Very nice. It's the only show where you'll see this. Man, I think. We just like to entertain. He's on Kyle's. It can be a bit boring, so we try and spice it up. So we come to an XJ6. Well, I've played. Done very well. He's only just over 2.5 years old. And he'll be trialling this winter for the nursery trials. And this is just a summer activity. Come on, Trev, over here. Have a bit of a rest.
Now you saw how it goes. Dog heard the duck. Is it that easier? Okay, so I'm looking for two volunteers. I'd like to. We like adults. We need an adult. Oh, we need an adult. Come on, Jaguar. Help me out. Put your hand up. Come on in. Right, you need to bring a friend. I'm one of the stars of the show, Jaguar XJ220.
The Jaguar Super. Come on, give a round of applause. He's going to come in and help out. Come on, young lady.
Owners of XJ220s include Ryan
right
Atkinson.
Now, we're going to have a little competition. Do you reckon two people can get the duck through the tunnel, over the side, faster than me and a dog? Right, okay, so that's what we're going to do. Here we're
going
to have our two duck herders. And we're
going to
give them each a pole. That's not for wax the
birds. Next we have a racing XJR15.
XJR15.
Nice registration, 1904D.
These are Magpie ducks. They are a bit noisy, this lot. Come on there, now you come, you lot. There you go.
Of course, the Jag 220 right registered now, as Jag 220.
The brown one, that's Kevin.
Quite nice. This is 1904 D. Betraying its racing heritage with its sponsors on the side. Emblazoned with a number 5. Metallic dark blue.
In the cockpit, so that's not turning. Our two new people here. Stay quite well wrapped. Okay. We want these ducks to stay quite quiet. Yep. And if you stay quite quiet and keep quite a distance,
and
you can actually
steer
these ducks.
It's a nice standard
easily,
solid
yep? Just like the sheep dog was
here's
doing, staying well back, that's what you've got to do. So we're gonna have
Marshall's
to stop what
miss
we're gonna do.
We
need to go over
lifting
the bridge.
Looking for
okay.
The
bearing a London registration.
We'll start when you get up that bridge and it will stop we have when you get through that tunnel. Right, so I would have one each side. Are you ready? Are you ready? Go! Come on then, let's have a bit of music, Andrew. Here we go. So, it's the quickest time. Time's going to start. I think go on around a bit. Go on around a bit. Where's the music? Oh, it's going to start in a minute, hopefully. Right, here they go. Hopefully off. The walkie-go ladies, get in there. Give a bit of force and pressure. Just a little bit, not too much.
Speed limited to 1.5, real speed.
Stop.
To next JS.
Have we got any music going on?
Sorry, registers.
Right, they're over there, first one.
Another one here.
Stopwatches going. Come on, young lady on the outside. You've got to put a bit of pressure on there.
2004.
Oh, they're going well today. Did everybody come out of Kevin's last again?
Very dark.
Oh, Kevin's like, oh no, they've missed. Turn around, come back. That's it, turn them back now, ladies. Come on, turn them back, turn them back.
And the 90s.
Stopwatches, still be going. Come on. Okay, don't miss the end of this time. You've got to run out. Oh no. One more go. Come on.
Nice long wheel base, jet black.
With a jet black. One face, oh, this is looking good there. Looking calm now.
Nice registration exit on the next JR.
Oh, no, you can't. Oh,
1980.
Best time. Right, oh, now a bit of pressure from the top. Come on, lady, at the top.
Lancashire registered.
Oh, quick. They're looking, oh, looking quite good now. Put a bit of pressure on there. Come on, you can do it. All up the side if they don't.
Next time, Yorkshire
just to
come out.
Oh, just forget it, go through the tunnel. Come on then, come on lady on the outside, run.
XJ6,
metallic
silver,
very
late,
come on, the last one, the stop is still going. God, Gilly, my little dog, we've got a good,
XJ6, private registration.
Right, give them a big round of applause. Right. Okay, you'd like to just stay over there in the corner there, because we're going to see if we can beat that time now. There is time penalty for missing objects.
Black.
So, we've got a little dog down here, and it's going to let her off for me. Of course, Jimmy, it's our first season doing the show this year. You get a little bit excited, so it doesn't make it as easy for me. But we're going to see if we can get the ducks with her over these obstacles. Now, Gilly, you're trying to balance the ducks.
Oh, so anyway, I hope you find it useful.
That means
and, bring
them
to your subscribers.
So, wherever I move, hopefully, he will bring them.
As I say, it's grown. When we took it
so, we're going to get them over there with speed up. This could be a mission impossible, I think. But we're going to try our best. Right.
Striking scarlet, metallic scarlet color. XJR, one nice little personalized plate. Convertible. Another one here, hard top. Lancashire
registered.
Oh, good stuff. XJR75, very nice.
They want to get back to their box. Right, we've got the right music actually coming.
Baz 234 is active usage spray. XKR, private place.
Gilly! Yeah, it wasn't the plan!
Nice light blue. black coloured convertible XKR private plate, very nice. And an F Type. Two F Types, in fact, Jaguar's new supercar. This one convertible in red with a Nottingham Lincoln area registration. F is Forest and Fens. One next to it is Oxford registered.
Yeah, it is now.
Top is in white. Very, very nice.
You start coming in here.
But for your wife, why not a yellowy top? Here we go. This car has nothing to do with the timeline, ladies just informed me, but it's still a very nice car and I have photographed it. It's a very nice E-Type convertible in lemon. Elite. 1970-71 registered.